What's going on, everybody? Doc from Average Gamer Guys. We're gonna jump into a little bit of Call of Duty Modern Warfare Remastered. I hop right into a game. And again, this episode is just gonna be me kind of playing around and talking the new update a little bit. We'll see if we're lucky enough, any of these folks, if they already have the new weapons. If you guys are not familiar, we did a video talking through all of them. The XMLAR, I got a chance to use it when I was playing with Sloth and we were kind of just grinding credits. It's a beast, guys. This thing is awesome. This is the weapon I want to unlock. I'm a big fan. I have a permanent unlock on the G36. Always been a fan of this weapon. Even more so than obviously the super overpowered M16. Even the AK and the M4. Big fan of the AK and M4. But the XMLAR, real steady. It's got a decent rate of fire, definitely slower than the M4, but really good stopping power, a lot of good solid damage it feels like with each hit. I ended up picking it up on Downpour and getting, I think I had about five or six kills maybe before I started using it, and I ended up going on a ruthless kill streak, which is 15 in a row, which I think is the highest I'd ever gotten on this version. Now, back when this was an Xbox 360 game and I played, I think I broke the 20s once or twice, but very rare. So it was just really interesting to see. That was only the second time I'd ever picked a weapon up. Just interesting. I like... Man, we're off to... killer start here. Ah, of course I get tagged. Good snipe by this guy. We'll watch that. That was on the move. That was a good hit. But we'll take the UAV. Pop that. Get that going. Oh. I don't know if I was being bumped there or moving around. Just did a Rocket League episode. Talked about, I kind of modified my, the settings on my router. Finally got an open NAT after what felt like forever. Saw this guy, good move, get up there. Which seemed like it helped me in Rocket League, to be really honest. This guy gets a headshot on me. Oh, that is not a headshot, come on. That guy was just rocking that thing. The 44 Magnum's another new weapon. Ooh, 30 headshots. Another new weapon they brought into the game. Which honestly feels just like a skin. I'm gonna be really honest with you. It plays a lot like that. It feels like that. The damage is, statistics are 100% the same as the Desert Eagle. So I'm not upset about that. Me and Sloth, when we were talking the update, we did kind of bring up the fact of, you know, one. Can you even classify this as a remaster anymore? I know, you know, it's never bad to bring new content, but I don't want it to sound like that. That is not what we're saying at all. We're 100% for bringing new content. You know, these guys trying out something different and just trying to bring a good experience. Honestly, new weapons, that's cool. I'm happy about that. In any normal game, that's exactly what I would want to see. Ooh, this guy, yeah. I think he missed, but gave it to him. In any normal game, that's 100% what you want to see. You'd want to see new content, you want to see new updates. You'd want to see all of those things. So it's hard to sit here and say we don't like it, because I think that's a false. I think that's false. I think people do like it. The question I just raise is it too... You know, one, are some of the weapons too overpowered? I think the XMLAR, with the stats that it has right now, it may be. It may fall into that category. Also, what I think the biggest complaint is, it's hard to put out content that essentially people are paying for. And that is not accessible to everybody, and is a purely luck-of-the-draw chance aspect. If it wasn't that, if you could do something to unlock them, you know, that might be a little bit different, but you're asking people to spend depot credits, which you can earn, 100% can earn for free just by playing the game. But as we've kind of talked about in our last video, we're not getting a lot of depot credits per game. I'm getting about 2. I think our average is about 2. That's just what it sits at. That's just what it is. Again, we might be playing the wrong game modes here, so there might be something better out there for us. Which, if you do know of something better or better way to do it, let us know. This is why I hate the M16 right here. Okay, 2 bursts. Surprised it wasn't 1. But, you know, you're not really able to unlock these things unless you're putting some money in. And I think that's the wrong approach, because again, especially with how prominent they are, that guy shot me through that barrier. That was a single hit. And I started the game off great. Not so good right now. Just on that. I don't know. Again, I think that's our biggest complaint with it. You know, it'd be different. And if it was like another weapon where you just... Are you kidding me? Wow. Man. Man, oh man. I don't know what to say here, guys. That thing didn't even move when he fired it. I trapped in here, which I don't like. If it was just another normal standard weapon that you could unlock based on time, or if you did something merit-based in the game, you know, you unlock something by using some of the other weapons, you completed certain challenges, got to a certain level, and then it would open up. You know, I think you're looking at something that might be a little bit different. People would be a little bit maybe more accepting of that fact. And I just seem to have a problem with the fact that, you know, again, they're asking you to spend more money after you've already bought the specialized edition, spent the money for the special version, you know, can't even... It would be different too if you could just buy this game straight up, but you can't. They haven't even allowed you to do that. So I just question, you know, is this the direction that they want to continue to go with this? And is this all of how their content is going to come to the game? You know, we saw some new maps. That was really cool. I was laying down here, so this is kind of dumb. Yep, killed me while I was still up. But I don't know. I don't think that's the direction you do want to go. Enemy UAV is airborne. That's not how you want to bring in, you know, new players. It's not how you honestly want to bring in new content. I'm all for all the cosmetic stuff. You can bring in whatever cosmetic stuff 100% that you want. You'll hear absolutely zero complaint from me. And again, which is why I don't have a problem with the 44 Magnum, minus the fact that, you know, you might be able to get lucky enough, unlock it when you're like a level 10 player, when really you shouldn't be getting it until you're a little bit later in the game. And they do that for a reason, because those weapons are more powerful. So that's kind of your reward for leveling up, continuing to play. And again, you see I got, I guess, kind of 2 depot credits there. Terrible game for me. 9-13. Really bad. But again, we're just here trying to grind some depot credits. Currently sitting at 10. Need 30 to unlock these. Which I also think is a little high, but I know it kind of lines up with Infinite Warfare. Looks like we got the next. I mean, I could buy common supply drops. That just doesn't make a whole lot of sense. Rares are definitely the way to go. They seem to do a good job comparatively to Infinite Warfare. These rare supply drops seem to be better on average, at least in my opinion, than some of the rare supply drops that you're getting in Infinite Warfare. Seems like there's more common legendary or, you know, epic drops in these, which is nice. But again, that was before, with the fact that it was all cosmetic stuff. And like I said before, I'm 100% fine. Bring whatever cosmetic stuff you want into the game. I have no problem with that. 100%. Zero problem. And the reason for that is it doesn't do anything for you. It doesn't change your play level as a player just because you have some cool camo or you got some cool emblem or anything like that. It's cool. It's a great way to show off. It's a great way to say, hey, I earned a lot of debug credits. I picked this stuff up. You know, that's why in the original Call of Duty 4, when this came out for 360, that's why I think a lot of people really tried to grind the weapons, which I'm trying to do right now with the G36, and get those camos. Because the camos were a great way to say, hey, I put a lot of time into this game. I'm really good with this weapon. I have 200 headshots. And I think that's neat. But what I think you end up missing... and ends up becoming a problem is when you start bringing in new weapons that people are just opening from crates that technically they could pay for, and it's changing the game. And that's where I think me and Sloth really agree here. That's the primary problem. And that's not what you want. You don't want people... Again, opening weapons that are above their skill level or above their player level because they're not putting the time in for them. And, you know, I expect everyone also in this game, they have 100% fair advantage or fairness because everybody can get the M16. Let's just be really honest. M16, by far the best weapon in this game. Everybody can get it. You don't have to be any special level. You don't have to be special in any way. Pick this up. You're just... As soon as you start, that's one of the base weapons you get. I don't know if it's by design that it's that good or what, but that's just what it ends up being. And that's okay, because everybody gets it. Everybody starts with it, no matter what class you have, how you start, you're getting it. I'd really like to kill this guy. There we go. Our UAV is online. ACOG right here. We haven't really seen it much. That's one other thing that I feel like I think has changed, or maybe it's just the player base playing the game. There never used to be quick scopes in this, which is, I think, one of the big allures for me. You didn't have to worry about kind of that. I don't know that I want to call it a cheap maneuver. But it's almost like you might as well not even zoom in the first place. That's kind of my opinion on it. But that's neither here nor there. Here to talk about the title update. And I think this game has a lot of nostalgia for a lot of people, just because, you know, it was one of the first games that they picked up, and they were pretty probably kind of serious in Call of Duty. I wish I could hit that guy in the head. I feel like I am. And so I don't know. I just don't know that you want to change the dynamic of that for this group of people that are playing this game. Because again, that's what they've come to know. That's what they've come to appreciate. That's the game they come to like. This guy seems like he's firing this really fast. Oh, I stand. I don't know. That's definitely my thoughts on it. I don't know. I think they may need to relook. That guy ran right past. I think they may need to relook. If they are intending to bring more weapons into this, how did I not hit that guy a single other time beyond that? More weapons into this game in the future, I'm all for that. All for... Our UAV is online. But just make it make sense. That's all I would ask. Should have been a double kill right there. Just make it make sense. And make it so that it's accessible to people that aren't going to pay for this. Pay for it. Because, again, I'm under the... You know, kind of under the thought process of, I've already bought Infinite Warfare, which not necessarily was a game that I wanted to begin with. You know, minus for the zombies. The zombies is absolutely awesome. So kudos to them. Kudos to them on the zombies. They did a 100% fantastic job. I'm super excited for the DLC. I don't want it to sound like I'm pooping on Infinite Warfare, but I'm just not a fan of the multiplayer. Ever since they started to make it so you can boost around the map, you're jumping, you're moving. It kind of took the combat away, for me at least. Made it something that it wasn't. It made it more about the movement than actually shooting someone. And that, to me, kind of takes away from it. You know, the fact that you can boost around, you can, you know, quick scope, and you can do all that. That's great. Happy for you, but that's not what the core of the game, to me, is supposed to be. And what Call of Duty was kind of founded on, which was staying on the ground and being a good, accurate shot. Like that, right there, right in the head. Seemed like a better game, but I got sidetracked talking. Hopefully I'm not rambling too much, but let's see. 9 and 12, so not too good either. I'm not really super excellent at the game. Because one, it's been a long time. Two, I refuse to use the M16, which puts me at a weapon disadvantage from time to time. But I will take that, and I will also take the victories. So I've also seen a lot of people talk about the shotgun. I've seen some people use it, although not very many, because I think it, again, these things are kind of hard to get. So if you're not spending money to crack them or to get enough salvage to open them, it's probably going to end up being the way I end up getting them, to be honest with you. I'm just going to keep opening crates and then hopefully getting some better items, even stuff. Honestly, I have the Brawler's Brew, which I think if you open again gives you 720 salvage, which that's a lot. So I'm kind of hoping that that I can open some of these. And on it, this is crazy. I only need one more thing for this. I didn't even realize that. Lucky enough to crack that, and then I get this gunslinger kit, which is really cool. So hopefully I'll open Nails as a character, and I can pick this up, because that is sweet. Look at that, guys. That's really awesome. And again, no issues with the cosmetic stuff. That is really cool. I'll actually be pretty happy if I do end up cracking that. I get Nails, the character, or whatever, and I can get that neat camo. I would definitely put that on my pistols. Them doing class-specific camos is neat. The one thing I think, and me and Slotha talked about this a little bit too, maybe a little overboard on the camos. I know you want to bring a lot of stuff in. No issues with that. But especially kind of Red Tiger being your premier camo as far as your weapons are concerned, it almost kind of feels, I don't know how to put it, it kind of feels not as worth it as much. More because people can just be opening camos and picking stuff up that looks a lot like it, or honestly looks better. So that's a consideration too. But again, no problems with any of that stuff. That is definitely shooting at me. Try to avoid getting hit here. People like to go in this bus. I think that guy was somewhere around there. Saw me, obviously. Woo! I don't know how I picked that up, guys. I do not know. I seriously do not. Where did this guy come from? Wow, that guy hit me a lot. Silence M9. That guy should probably take the silencer off of that. That was a lot of bullets. Either I'm sponging really good. I don't have Juggernaut on. I always run stopping power. That's just personal preference. I think you need it, especially to stay competitive with some of the weapons. like that right there, I was lucky enough, I was able to take a couple hits and then turn on that guy when he had to reload. I could have finished that kill, that would have been great. Not really want where you want to be in a sniper-centric map. Looking out like this. Wow. I didn't really realize that you could see that. From there, interesting. Not where I was expecting to get shot from, I'll tell you guys that. 100%. I went for the headshot there. And trying to grind headshots, I actually think I'm in the 90s with this weapon, which is not terrible. Really not terrible for me. But yeah, honestly, I would like to finish this, hopefully, maybe by the time I get that XMLAR, I will have it. I shouldn't have aimed there, I should have just went pure 100% from the hip. UAV is something we haven't had in a minute. Knowing my luck with these depot boxes and all this stuff, I'll probably end up getting like the shotgun or something. The one weapon I don't really want. Instead of the XMLAR, that's just how these things kind of go. I won't be mad if I get any of the weapons, to be honest. I think they're all pretty neat. I picked up my weapon and killed me with it. That's never a good day. Enemy UAV is airborne. UAV being up. Seems like they've had that a lot during this game. What? Where is this guy's grenade? I have to see this. Wow. And it just sits there. Magnetic grenades. Me and Sloth weren't kidding. I believe that's a thing in this game. Enemy UAV is airborne. Man, this guy is just tearing me up with this G3, which is, that is a good weapon. I was a fan of the single shot weapons a lot. M14 is pretty good, but you definitely have to find a cadence. The G3 is probably more my favorite just because it doesn't have as bad of a kick. Still really good damage output. Kind of just random grenade, we'll see if it hit though. Little luck there. Accuracy, it's been kind of up and down with this. Guy using Juggernaut is frustrating. I'm surprised I got that kill. We're almost out of 36 ammo. Have to find something else. Got this guy's. And again, I can't tell if this is red Tiger or oh, beautiful. And I need the headshots, guys. I need those headshots. 110%. Now this is pretty dumb. There are a lot of other places that you could camp. Standing on the ladder seems like an interesting choice. There's another beautiful headshot. I will take these headshots all day. Tell somebody. I was not paying attention. That guy totally got me. Oh, that's what I get. That is what I get for trying to be cheeky. The assists, I will take those. All the points I can get, especially with double experience. Just running till the 13th. A little bit of time to get that. Our UAVs online. How I didn't kill that guy is beyond me. That grenade. Like a really good grenade. Either reload here. AK-74U, another one of my favorite weapons. Not big on the submachine guns, not big on using them a lot. But if I had to pick one, where does this guy come from? If I had to pick one, that would be the one I 100% want to use. I know the MP5 is super overpowered. It just kind of comes with the territory, I think. I had his RPG out. Interesting. Let's see that wall. Here. He's not! He's laying down. And I knew this guy was going to continue to camp here. Okay, excuse you. Do it. Interesting last kill there. But yeah, that's kind of my thoughts on this. I know me and Sloth have talked about it a little bit. We'll kind of continue to talk about it. Again, going to continue to play this game, continue to try to grind some depot credits, open up some crates for you guys. Hopefully be lucky enough to open that weapon, because it is a weapon I want to use, because it seems like it fits my playstyle. Pretty steady weapon, good damage, not a lot of recoil. We're really going to be getting some good damage out of it. So, hopefully you guys enjoyed. I've been Doc with the Average Gamer, guys. Let me know your comments down below what you think about the update. If you enjoyed it, please make sure to hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and we will check you next time. Thanks for watching.